The appalling truth about how Tyra Henry had suffered during her short life began to emerge after she was dumped in the arms of a nurse on the steps of Guy's Hospital. With her was a note saying, "I'm leaving my little girl for you to take care of, as I'm scared and running away from my boyfriend who has beaten us both up." Tyra was in a terrible state, black and blue, covered in bite marks and suffering from severe head injuries. Surgeons operated immediately, she was put on a ventilator, but 3 days later, Tyra was dead. By then, her mother, 19-year-old Claudette Henry, seen here on her way to court, had turned up at Guy's to see her baby. When Tyra died, police started looking for her father, Andrew Neal. By the time he'd given himself up at Brixton Police Station and been charged with murder, the role of Lambeth Social Services was already coming under the magnifying glass. In May 1983, Andrew Neal had been found guilty of assaulting the couple's other child. 3-year-old Tyrone had been left brain damaged and partially deaf. The conviction was later quashed, but Tyra was placed in Lambeth Council's care. A safe house in Tulse Hill was arranged for mother and child at the home of Tyra's grandmother, Beatrice Henry, well out of the way of the child's father. But unknown to social workers, Tyra's mum took the child back to Evelyn House, Bonham Road, Brixton, just 30 yards away from where the father, Andrew Neal, was living. A report was commissioned by Lambeth into the circumstances surrounding Tyra's death. The independent childcare specialists accused social workers of professional shortcomings, being naive, of having too liberal a professional outlook. Disciplinary action was recommended against 2 supervisory social workers. But no one has so far been disciplined. The social services director thought such action would be bad for staff morale. The unions had threatened to strike if their members took the rap.
What we have been very angry about has been the attempted witch hunt against social workers, is if they are to blame for her death. It's totally wrong. The care programme was worked out in conjunction with everybody, the relations, the court, all other agencies. Lambeth social workers acted completely properly, and we totally reject any allegation that we're covering up or hiding anything. We're willing to discuss any point about the case at any time, but in front of people who are experts, who are neutral, and who haven't been involved in the formulation of a Lambeth Council childcare policy. We want a fully independent view adopted.
The opposition on Lambeth are calling for the resignation of Social Services Chair Janet Boateng. They say the whole childcare policy places too much emphasis on keeping families together, whatever the risk to a child.
There must be more monitoring, and there's certainly got to be more supervision, and maybe more training in child abuse, and a general look at policies generally with regard to children brought into care. The initial decision to allow the child to go to the grandmother was wrong. We were made a ward of court of that child. It was in our care, and we should have either fostered that child or kept that child in one of our children's homes and looked at the position over a long view to see if at the end of the day the young mother could have had the child. She was very young, very immature, and it would have given her time to see whether she wanted a child, and it would have protected the child.
From the research that I have done, some 50% of child abuse cases are in fact already known to the social workers, and clearly too many social workers seem to relate to the parents and don't look at the case from the point of view of the children. And I think we must emphasize that while the family unit is vital, that in this sort of case where children are at risk from single parent families, from bad housing, from people who are unemployed, from marriages which are not the normal marriage, they are perhaps common law situations, that in this situation social workers that should always look from the point of view of the children, where the interests of the children lie, and not of the parents. And I believe that if this is the case, that many fewer of these cases will occur.